Salutations, my friends, and welcome back to Robocraft League of Mechs. Now, we are still enjoying the beautiful Hollowfest update. I still have my pumpkins here in the garage, but as you see, we are back to an empty garage again. So, what am I going to build today? I actually have an idea. Now, I've seen a lot of two-leg mech robots, and I've seen quite a bit of four-leg mech robots. But I have yet to see a one-leg mech or a three-leg mech. Now, I kind of like the idea of a one-leg pogo stick style mech, but it seems impractical, so we're going to go for the three-legged mech. And I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do this. I might borrow some design elements from my previous robot, but I think maybe a mech with three legs might actually be really good. So let's check this out. Now, for this build, I think I'm going to go with entirely TX1 blocks. Or I'm sorry, Mark 11 blocks. I'm not sure what you call it now. But we're going to go primarily with just these, just for strength and for their lightweight capability. Now, it is going to be very CPU intensive, so it will limit the size of the robot a lot. But I'll get around that with some electro plates, and hopefully we can make everything work out. Alright, let's start with the primary platform. Now this is a three-legged robot, so I should probably go pretty wide. I'll raise that up a bit. Grab a few of these legs. I should have three purchased. I'll go ahead and throw one in the dead center. And two on the sides. That actually doesn't look too bad. I'll go ahead and take these off. And we'll fill this in a bit. Alright, and try to give this thing a little bit of style, so we'll be using a few arrow rods. Now, I imagine I'm gonna put my cockpit in the center, and we might need to extend this out just a tiny bit. 3x3 looks a little bit weak. So we'll make a spot there for the cockpit. Maybe raise this up a little bit. We'll extend this in the backward. We'll extend this in the back. That looks a bit better. We'll add these in the front. Just one more layer of protection. Alright, I like the way that looks. We could perhaps round off these corners a bit. Oh yeah, that's much better. Not too bad. I'm gonna go ahead and place the cockpit. I need to see how tall this thing is. I want to be able to actually cover it up completely. That looks like it might work. We'll leave that there. Add a few of these. We can lace these down the back. I might actually run out. I like the look of that so far. Let's see how long the arrow rod is. Is this gonna work? I'm not sure about the spacing. Like a bit too long for that one. And we are one block short. might need to extend our robot out a little bit wider. That would make it a tad bit weaker though. Let's see, is it just one more? Oh, I do like the look of that. It looks very tough. Perhaps we'll put one here and one there. Actually have a better idea. Let's make this cockpit one block wider. Let me try these. No, that's not quite gonna look right. Give us a little bit more structural integrity. That's gonna eat up a lot of CPU though. It doesn't look too bad. I'm gonna clean up these sides a bit. And what can I do here? Let's try a corner piece. Looks like we're missing a block here and there. I'll put those back. Alright, now let's try our rods. Let's see how they look. It's not too bad, I like it. Kind of looks like it's some kind of actuator. Let's go ahead and throw some shielding on this thing. That's going to be very important with this bot. I actually like these shields a lot in the front. I'm probably going to use this again. Can we go down one lower? Yes, we can. That doesn't look like a very good mounting spot though. Looks a little bit weak there. But I would like to add some skirts. A little more protection. Let's grab one of these corner blocks. And clean this thing up a little bit. Much better. Pretty good so far. Oh, this shield is a bit tall though. We might actually have to go down one. Yeah, our shield is going to interfere with our gun. Now, I think for this build we're going to go with a plasma setup. And if I put this thing up here, is it going to clear? I know it has a bit of a volley to it, so it might be alright. It does look a little bit tall. I have to move these down one further. And I'll give it a bit of reinforcing in the back. That should help. And that would actually give us an additional mounting point. But I think we should keep it like that. I want to keep the mass mostly in the center. I'm sure that's where they're going to direct their fire, is on the center of the robot. Oh, that looks a lot better. I think they'll actually clear now. Now, can we stick one here? And perhaps here on the sides? Let's stick one on the side first. There we go. We'll keep it in the center as well. Alright, so that gives us 5 plasmas. We're gonna need a little bit more. I could go with the TX1 plasma on the top, but we'll skip that for now. Let's try backing you up a little bit. Let's move you back as well. That actually gives us the clearance we need. We put one there and one there. And we have a whole lot of plasma in a very small area. Can we move you forward? Yes, we can. I actually like the way that looks. It's not too bad. Now, we need to reinforce with a bit more shielding. Let's see what we can do here. This will be a bit tricky. Definitely want to add more shielding here. Let's take these off. If I add a few of these smaller ones, I wonder if they'll get in the way. Looks like they're okay there. Now, what about the attachment point? That's the wrong shield. Like it is actually in the way. That one's okay though. Let's move you down one. It'll give me a bit more reinforcement. And let's try putting these back. Hopefully they don't get in the way. Alright, we're a little bit tougher in the front now. Add some shielding in the back. Looks like it's gonna be in the way. That doesn't look too bad. We still have quite a bit of CPU to spare. See if anything interesting fits. That's kind of neat. Oh, looks like it's gonna bump into him over there. I really would like to get these in the front. But it looks like I'm not gonna have the space. We're going to be crouching a lot, so I think the actual angle for them to be angled down is not going to be too beneficial for us. Let's see what else we have here. A few of these might work. These are actually my favorite shields. Try to squeeze 2 into place. Back. That's not too bad. Oops, deleted that. And then let's see what these look like. Still a little bit conflicting with the gun. That's not too bad. Gives us a bit of protection. Definitely for the arrow rods, at least. I wonder how that would work in the front. Let's actually try moving this and seeing if it even clears it. Not on this side. Oh, looks like it's not gonna fit. There has to be an interesting shield option where I can still fit a few guns in. I'm determined we're gonna make this happen. Looks like that's a bit too shallow. If I was to put a block here and here and make this longer, I could move everything back a little bit. But CP might become an issue. I'm gonna check this side. Looks like it's still conflicting. That's kind of neat, but definitely in the way. Looks like I need to attach here. Maybe they're just too close together. Oh, that actually works really well. And I see we have an attachment point here at the bottom. Is it able to fit a gun? It's close. Maybe with an arrow rod, I'll be able to clear that. Now that is going to mess with our side plasmas a bit, so we'll have to extend this out as well. Make everything a bit wider. Bring this out a little bit. It looks like we have run out of TX cubes. Let's head over and try to buy some more of these things. Have a terrible amount of galaxy cash, or RPM, sorry. So hopefully 40 will get it done. I'll have to do a bit more grinding. Okay, so we got 40 more blocks. It's probably all the CPU we can handle anyway. Should round that out a bit. It is becoming quite tanky. Now let's try putting this back. Right, that's quite a bit better. I like the shielding here in the front a lot more. The CPU is getting high. No more arrow rods either. Oh my. I'll have to steal one of you real quick. Put that there. That does allow me to forward mount them. But they are sticking about a bit too far. So let's remove one of these blocks. I'll try that again. Oh, is it in the way? What's it in the way of? Oh, the actual shield is touching it. Okay, so it definitely has to stick out that far. Well, that's not a terrible loss. We'll face these down. I do worry about these arrow rods falling off pretty quickly. But this is a very cool mounting solution. What happens if we spread it out even further? Does it make a difference? Well, it looks like the plasma is still clear. Looks looks like with a 2-block extension it will fit. I'm getting dangerously close to the edge of my CPU. It does look a bit better attached, so I'm gonna put these back. Do a bit of reinforcing on this. Wrong block. That's pretty good. It's definitely tougher than an arrow rod. I'll try the same thing here. Extend this out just 1 block. That should give us quite a bit of firepower and the ability to soak up some damage. Now, if they are able to chew through an entire section of the arrow rods, it will remove the pod, so that is a little bit scary. Stick one of these in the back. Looks like we just have enough CPU to do it. It is looking rather tanky, very tough. I think what we should do is forego those temporarily, and let's create a central column of just these stronger blocks. Might be a bit more forgiving. And perhaps I can attach a couple of those curved ones. Looks like they might fit. We're just a little bit too close, and we'll be back one. That actually looks best there. How close is our CPU? Very close. So that gives us a little bit better of attachment to our side pods. Now what else can we do here? I don't quite have enough for thrusters. More arrow rod connection points wouldn't hurt. Maybe a few more TX1 blocks in exchange. This is tricky. It always gets difficult when you come down to the last part of your CPU. I never know quite how to spend it. Could try to lighten it up a bit with some helium, but I'm not sure that it would help much. Looks like just not quite enough for that. And definitely not enough there. Well, I don't think we need a whole lot of shielding in the back. Let's try removing these three and see if we have any other available shield options. Maybe something with just 2 pieces. Protection of the arrow rods is mostly the essential part. Doesn't look too bad. That would be ideal. it looks like I'm hitting on the gun. Can it be moved forward? No, it cannot. Oh, that would have been quite nice. Still, I could make it one block more. I do have the CPU. That's kind of cool. But I'm really worried more about the rods than I am the center cockpit. Does that provide enough protection? This one seems to cover the rods a lot more. I can even go down a bit lower, but they seem to peek over, so I think that's the one we want to go with right there. Get those out of here. We don't need those. Oops. I still want those, though. And just a few CP remaining. Be enough to connect here. Bit, and we have 1 point left. That's actually perfect. That should give me enough for my new bronze ranking badge. We should be able to put this thing just about anywhere. Well, it looks like one of the top two. That doesn't look too bad. Alright, so there we are, 15 and 11. Flops. We've got 7 plasmas. Quite a bit of shielding this time. Got shielding behind shielding, some redundant shielding. A lot of TX1 blocks here. Now, I could remove these arrow rods for the equivalent of tier 10 blocks, which would give it a lot more beef, but I actually like the aesthetics. I'm gonna leave that alone. Let's go give it a quick test and see what it drives. It looks interesting. I like the badge on the back. I'm not sure if it's just me, but it seems a bit lighter. It seems faster. I like the tripod design. Now, I do plan on spending the entire time in combat crouched down, so it'll give me a much lower profile. Make it a bit more difficult to deal with. Let's check the tracking of our plasma. Shoot us some high targets. That one's a little bit off, so you gotta make sure you're pointing directly at the target. You need to be square facing. Looks like they're all hitting pretty well. Let's try this one here. Yeah, not too bad at all. They seem to converge on one spot, so that should work out well for us. Now, I've been reading on the forums and in some comments that they should implement, and I agree with this idea, maybe a run feature or a sprinting feature with these mech legs where you can sprint, but then you are not able to fire while sprinting, and there's also a cooldown period, so you can't just sprint across the whole map. Yeah, that might actually be a cool feature to add, because right now they're really limiting the gameplay just because of the speed factor. Now, there is a trade-off, you know, they're tanky, but they're actually so slow, and the maps are so big, that without a smaller map, it's kind of hard to make them effective. In the pit, though, they are a lot of fun, so they're always there for that. Alright, let's head back to the mothership. Alright, so I really like this new robot. It seems to work pretty well. I'll be taking it into combat to test it soon. I think the final step is I need to come up with a name for this thing, and I actually already have a good idea. We're gonna call this guy Tripod. If I can get the keyboard to work. Or my fingers to work. Alright, we've got the Tripod. Doesn't look too bad. Might be pretty tough. It's got a lot of armor, a lot of TX1 blocks, but anyway, this is a good place to wrap this episode up. Thank you guys for joining me, and we will see you next time.